Now that Title Update 9 has gone live, and we have no new content to experience, players are looking for build concepts to try to assemble to experience what we currently have in new and interesting ways. Crowd control and utility builds are becoming popular, and with this pyro build, you'll not only contribute to your squad's effectiveness, you'll have a blast setting the world on fire. What's going on, agents? It's Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer, and I'm excited to be bringing you this pyro build to add to your arsenal of crowd control builds. And this one was not only exciting to put together, but can really be a lot of fun to use. But before we begin the build guide, if you haven't yet taken the time to hit that sub button for dedicated division content, please do so. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to receive all notifications for my YouTube channel. And with that out of the way, let's begin the build guide. First off, let me explain to you how I approached this pyro build, and it is built around status effects and skill haste. Now, this version of the pyro build will not deal the absolute most damage, but it does get your skills back off of cooldown and ready to catch more targets on fire as quickly as possible. For the mask, I have used the first of my two Wyvern Wear gear pieces with status effects and skill haste, along with a skill haste utility mod. The body armor gives you a lot of flexibility, and I have again chosen to equip Wyvern Wear for the 10% skill damage and 10% status effects for equipping two pieces of this gear set. There are many interesting body armor talents, but I decided to go with Glass Cannon, very specifically for the lore text of all damage you deal is amplified by 25%. Two important items to know about Glass Cannon are that this added damage applies to your skills, and amplified damage is a multiplicative damage type, so it means even more damage than a standard skill damage talent. For the attributes, I have a max status effect roll and would ideally want skill haste as well, although I haven't been able to find a suitable body armor gear piece to equip. The holster will require you to do some serious farming, but the Imperial Dynasty holster pairs beautifully with this pyro build. This exotic gear piece features the Dragon's Glare talent that sets targets within 20 meters of your position on fire every 35 seconds. Now, although the talent states every 35 seconds, it is currently affected by higher levels of skill haste and comes down off of cooldown even faster. For the backpack, I am using a piece of China Light for the 15% explosives damage, along with status effects and skill haste as the attribute rolls, and a skill haste mod. The Creeping Death talent is ideal for this pyro build, as once you set a target on fire, it can spread to targets within 8 meters of that initial target and can quickly spread through entire mobs. I like the extra explosive damage from the China Light piece, as it enhances the initial impact of the burned sticky bomb before I detonate the bomb. For the gloves, I am using one piece of Hana Yu for the 10% skill haste, along with maximum skill haste and status effects attribute rolls. The knee pads were difficult to loot, but Golden Gear awards the build with 10% status effects for equipping one piece, and I have again targeted skill haste and status effects as the attribute rolls. As an alternative, you could equip a second and third piece of China Light in place of the Hana Yu and Golden Gear pieces to achieve the exact same brand set bonuses. Now, I have had issues farming the exact China Light pieces I want, so I went with Hana Yu and Golden Gear. For the weaponry, the named M4, the Pyromaniac, would be the obvious choice, but I wanted to change things up and have instead chosen to use the MK17 rifle with Perpetuation. Now, this weapon talent works really well with crowd control skill builds, as when you connect with a headshot, you receive 50% status effects damage and duration to the next status effect you apply. So the idea is to hit your headshot and then apply the burn status effects while the perpetuation timer is active. For the secondary, I have again chosen the Sweet Dreams exotic shotgun solely for the Sandman melee talent versus non-elite NPCs. Alternative weaponry could include any weapon archetype that you choose, just make sure it includes Ignited as the weapon talent. For the skills, I am using the Burn Sticky Bomb, along with Damage and Duration mods. Now, since this pyro build is at a skill tier 6, the Burn Sticky Bomb hits for 3.6 million damage, cools down in 15.9 seconds, and continues to burn targets for a whopping 45 seconds once they are set on fire. The second skill to equip is the Firestarter Chem Launcher, and when you are at skill tier 6, this will burn targets for 251,000. Burns for 13.3 seconds, has 7 rounds, and acquires another round off cooldown every 14 seconds. I have equipped a Skill Haste and Burn Strength mod to finish off the Chem Launcher. For the specialization, I am of course using the Firewall kit, as it has so many talents that complement this pyro build. Enriched Magnesium Formula adds 20% to burn duration. Firewall Tactical Link grants my teammates 10% additional damage to targets that are within 10 meters of my position. And if my armor breaks, Fiery Response will proc and apply burn to enemies within 5 meters of me. And I can't forget to mention the actual specialized weapon, the Flamethrower, as once you use it to set targets on fire, all your status effects will stack onto the targets you have applied burn damage to. And finally, if you really want to get specific with your build, spec into skill damage, skill haste, and skill duration and your shade rank points. Now the way that I like to play this build is I push forwards in front of my squad and attempt to light as many targets on fire as quickly as I can. I use the burn sticky bomb to hit hardened targets and incapacitate them quickly, and then switch to my Firestarter Chem Launcher to fire off clouds of flammable gas. Now, if you know the spawn points within missions, you can preemptively place clouds in front of spawn closets and then set them on fire as they open, and the NPCs attempt to spill out. Now, while all of this is going on, I also attempt to use grenades and the Flamethrower to light additional targets on fire. In the background, the Imperial Dynasty holster will catch the closest targets within 20 meters of me on fire, and then if it is not on cooldown, Creeping Death will cause all of these burn status effects to spread to additional targets, and eventually, everything around you is on fire. What makes this build so useful is that once you have set all of these targets on fire, they not only continue to take damage from your burn status effects through ticks, but they can't aim their weapons or deploy skills as they are attempting to put out the flames. On a side note, I can tell you that for the body armor, I have experimented with Trauma, Unbreakable, Skilled, and several other talents, and you can use whatever you want and whatever complements your playstyle. Also, if you do not have the Imperial Dynasty holster, it is known to be a rare drop from Vivian Conley, the final boss on the Stranded Tanker mission in New York City. Now, if you do not own the Warlords of New York expansion, you cannot loot this holster. So you could use a piece of Hanayu or even craft a no-name holster for the extra mod slot. This is going to wrap up this Pyro build guide, and as always, I look forward to reading your comments, and I encourage feedback and interaction in the comments section below. If you haven't yet done so, please smash that sub button, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to receive all notifications from my YouTube channel. If you liked the video, rate it with a thumbs up, if not with a thumbs down. If you feel like supporting my full-time YouTube content creation, please check in the video description for links to my Patreon page and Buzz merch store. Follow me on Twitter for all my latest thoughts concerning most things gaming-related with a heavy emphasis on the Division franchise. And finally, make sure to stay tuned for clips of me using this exact build in heroic difficulty missions. And until my next upload, this is Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer, signing off.
Looks like that key card is...